Good morning, friends. In previous video, we have seen what is definition of reproduction, and the further topic was asexual reproduction and its type. In today's video, we are going to focus sexual reproduction and structure of flower. So sexual reproduction is the process which involves fusion of two gametes or fusion of two sex cells. So here gametes, you can say the gonads are there in the sexual reproduction. It may be male gamete or it may be female gamete. Both are coming together to form new individual is nothing but the sexual reproduction. Organism should not reach to maturity phase before reproduction, because if the organism is going to be going to reach at maturity phase before reproduction and the growth is incomplete, at that condition the young one which is forming because of the reproduction is not as genetically and morphologically identical to their parents one. Or you can say that particular species may have deficiency, that particular organism may suffer from any diseases. That's why it is necessary that whenever any organism is going to reproduce, the organism should reach to maturity after growth phase, not before that. Okay, so plant should end up with their juvenile, that is vegetative phase, to start reproduction. Here in this chapter we are focusing towards the reproduction in plants only. So in case of plant, they should first finish with their vegetative phase. It means their growth should complete, root growth is should be completed, and then it is enter in reproductive phase so that they can reproduce properly. And the new young ones which are forming from that particular process is exactly similar to their parents. So actually, there are five classes in the kingdom Plantae, that is Thallophyta, Bryophyta, Pteridophyta, Gymnosperm and Angiosperm. In that, Thallophyta, Bryophyta and Pteridophyta are called as lower plants because they are not having well-developed structure of flower. Okay, though some organelles are absent, some are in developing condition, so they are called as lower plants. Mostly angiosperms are called as higher plants, and angiosperms commonly called as flowering plant because they produce prominent, highly specialized organ which is called as flower. For what? For sexual reproduction. And after that, fruits and seeds are formed after the formation of flower. So in sexually reproducing plant, two phases are so much important, that is diploid phase called as sporophyte and haploid phase called gametophyte. What is diploid phase of sporophyte? First you should know what is meaning of diploid. Diploid, we are writing diploid as twice in. It means 46 number of chromosomes are present. The cell which having 46 number of chromosome is called as diploid cell. And that those cells are called as sporophytes. So in the plants which are going to reproduce sexually, their first step is that they should have the sporophyte, that is diploid phase is completed. So diploid cells should be present in those plants. The next is, unless and until the sporophytes are not grown properly, they are not going to produce haploid cell. It means gametophyte. And we are writing haploid like this, only N. Okay, the meaning of N is half number of chromosome. Chromosome number is 23. Those cells are called as haploid cell. First sporophyte should be grown properly, then sporophyte having capacity to form haploid cell, that is gametophyte. So these are two alternative phases which are necessary for sexually reproducing plant. In angiosperm, plant itself a diploid, highly differentiate sporophyte, whole organism. It means the leaves of the plant, the stem of the plant, then the vessels of the plant, the cells which are present in all these organelles of the plant having the sporophyte. While haploid male and female gametes are microscopic in the plant structure. Diploid zygote is initial stage of sporophyte. It means that as I explained just a few minutes before, that sporophytes are going to reproduce, going to produce the gametophyte. So their first stage of first stage should be what? The diploid zygote should be proper, that is sporophyte should be proper, then and then they are going to produce the haploid microspore. Microspore or megaspore? Microspore is male gamete while megaspore is female gamete. This microspore and megaspore are initial cells of male and female gametophyte respectively. Okay, so this is all about introductory part. Now we are going to focus structure of flower. Actually, this topic is dirty in 11th standard only, but here we are going to study the reproduction in plant. That so I think that I should revise this topic. So site of reproduction, sexual reproduction in plant is flower. It is the most attractive part of the flower, which produces scent and nectar. Scent and nectar is required for the pollination. The pollination is the further topic which we are going to study in this chapter. Okay, so now to explain this flower structure of flower, I have drawn one chart over here. Okay, the structure of flower. Structure of flower involves two main parts, that is essential whorls and accessory whorls. What is the meaning of essential whorls? The parts of the plants which are actually involved in reproduction process, those parts are called as essential whorls of the flower. And accessory whorls, the parts of the plants which are not involved in reproduction. Somehow they are helping for reproduction and doing other function of the plant. Then those part of the flowers are called as accessory whorls. So first we'll talk about this essential whorls. So essential whorls, two parts of the flower are in the essential whorls. First is androecium. Androecium is called as male reproductive part. Single unit of androecium is called as stamen. Okay? Gynoecium is called as female reproductive part, and single unit of gynoecium is called as carpel. So I'll show the androecium and gynoecium to you in this diagram. Okay, you are able to see. This is gynoecium, single unit of gynoecium, that is female reproductive part, and its single unit is called as carpel. While these are the androecium. Androecium are many in number in the flower. Okay, and the single unit of androecium is called as stamen. Separately, I have drawn the diagram of carpel and stamen as well. So this is carpel. You can say it is a gynoecium, and it having three parts: stigma, this is the style, and the small round shape ovary. Okay, and the stamen having two parts: anther and the filamen. Stamen is the single unit of androecium, that is male reproductive part. When androecium and gynoecium come together, fuse, they are going to produce your seed, that is zygote. So they are called as essential whorls. Accessory whorls, they are helping for reproduction. They are doing other functioning, for example, growth, photosynthesis, etc. All this function of the plant is done with the help of this accessory whorl. So actually four parts are involved in accessory whorl, that is pedicel, thalamus, calyx, and corolla. Okay, so first I'll explain you what is pedicel. Pedicel is stalk of the flower, which is green in color and supportive to the flower and doing perform photosynthesis. So this is pedicel, stalk of the flower, which is green in color. Main function is to support the flower, and another one, as it is green in color, it having chlorophyll pigments, so it performing photosynthesis. So next part is called as thalamus. It is bulb like part, and which is present at the end of the flower, which is green in color, hold all the parts together. Okay, so this bulgy portion is called as thalamus, which is again green in color. So again, it perform somehow little bit perform photosynthesis. The main function is to hold all the different parts of the flower together. That is the main function of thalamus. Next part is calyx. You are able to see this small petal or leaf like structure. These are called as calyx. The group of and the single unit of calyx is called as sepals. So all sepals come together, and that group is called as calyx, which is green in color. So again, it performs photosynthesis. And the main function of calyx is it protect androecium and gynoecium in bud condition. Whenever the flower is in bud condition, all the androecium and gynoecium are undeveloped or in developing stage. So the main aim of the calyx is to protect androecium and gynoecium in the bud condition. And the last part, which is accessory whorl of the flower, that is corolla. Okay, the single unit of corolla is called as petal, which are colorful. Okay, and the group of petals are called as corolla. So as it is colorful, the main function is to attract insect for the pollination. And again, it protect androecium and gynoecium, because androecium and gynoecium are present inside the petals. So it is again the function of corolla. So this is all about structure of flower. Structure of flower having two parts, essential whorl and accessory whorls. Essential whorls having two parts, androecium and gynoecium, while accessory whorl having four parts, pedicel, thalamus, calyx and corolla. I hope that I have revised the topic shortly to you. Now next, the process of sexual reproduction in plant. In short, I am explaining this with the help of this pie chart. Actually in your book it is given in paragraph, but instead of paragraph, if you are, I think that we are going to understand this topic properly with the help of this pie chart. So I have drawn this. So first process of this sexual reproduction is microsporogenesis and megasporogenesis. Microspore is a male gamete, so formation of male gamete is nothing but microsporogenesis, and formation of female gamete is nothing but the megasporogenesis. Megaspore is a female gamete. So first step actually, so it is necessary of course that male and female gamete should be produced. So they are producing with the help of two processes, microsporogenesis and megasporogenesis. So this is the first step. Remember one thing, that both the processes should be performed simultaneously, because if male gamete is properly developed and female gamete is not properly developed and they are fusing together, then the seeds are not developed, or the young ones which are forming, they may have disabilities, or vice versa. If for example female gamete is properly developed and male gamete is not properly developed, then again the zygote is not developed properly. So that's why it is necessary that microsporogenesis and megasporogenesis should be done simultaneously in the plant. Okay, so second step is development of this male and female gamete. This is again done simultaneously. After development, pollination is done. It may pollination is of two types, self-pollination and cross-pollination. Self-pollination is done when androecium and gynoecium, this male and female gametes, are present in single flower, so they can self-pollinate themselves. They can fuse with each other themselves with the help of wind, okay, no, or by means of other things. And if the male flower or female flowers are different, for example, papaya having male and female flowers are different. So they need their cross-pollination takes place. It means pollination done with the help of some vectors. It may be insect, it may be wind, etc. So we are going to see this pollination topic in detail further. Okay. So third process is pollination. Fourth one is fertilization. Fertilization is the important. It means fusion of male and female gamete. And when male and female gamete fuse together, they form fruits, that means seed, that is our zygote or the new young one. And when we are pouring this seed into the soil, again it produces new plant. So this way the sexual reproduction takes place in the plant. I hope you understand the topic. Okay, thank you.